You're next in line for the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up,
and please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we are back with podcast number 015. This is the Holiday World Pod Squad here for the official Holiday World podcast. Today is Friday, August 26th. The title of today's episode is The One with the See You in September. My name is Paula, and I'm here with our Pod Squad, Matt, Eric, and Lauren. Say hello everybody.
Hello.
We're ruts. We travel in packs.
Yeah. Okay. We have to explain what that means. We thought finally... We're not open today.
Which would explain the attitude that we all have right now. We're a bit giddy and a bit
rested.
Is that what that is?
I'm still bouncing back.
That's true. This is a well-rested Eric Renz.
Yes.
All right, Lauren, explain what that was.
When I was young, like early grade school, I think like second, third grade-ish, I wrote, it sounds too official because I really just made it up in my head and I never wrote it down anywhere, but I came up with songs.
Cause you were going to be a jingle writer.
That's where I thought I was going to go with that. But I just, sang to the group before we started recording one of the major hits that I came up with called We're Rats, We Travel in Packs.
All right, let's hear it.
Oh no,
we have to do it.
Okay, here we go. We're rats, we travel in packs. We always know the facts. We're often nice and pick up mice. We're rats, we travel in packs.
See, that is amazing.
I think it's great.
And so just to give you a little history, the conversation led down this path because I thought Lauren should write some jingles for our podcast to do our sound bites that, you know, I think we desperately need. And we found out
desperate.
Now that we know what talent we have on the squad. I mean, seriously. Think of what we could do and where we could go now.
This could be, yeah.
So you didn't have to write that down because it is so darn catchy that Eric Renz will not stop singing it.
It's on a loop in my head, the repeat.
And it's like, dear listeners, we finally, everybody got here on time. It's like, we're going to start at the exact right time. No, we're singing jingles and talking about things that... We won't record, most probably. I want to also give a shout out before we really dig into everything yesterday, or maybe it was a couple days ago, thinking of our dear Leah and Leah's Oboe, to be found at Leah's Oboe on Twitter, is working on her MBA up at IU, the Kelly School of Business. And we all miss her. So I wanted to say we miss you, Leah. So it was yesterday evening. So I don't want to act like I gave her that much warning, but
we miss her oboe too.
Yeah, we do.
And it tweeted this week.
It did.
Mm-hmm. What did it say?
We'll honk. Get to that later. It says honk or squeak, but we will mention.
His vocabulary is not real diverse.
July 4th, it said freedom with reed with capitalized. Reed. But it was very clever of the oboe.
It is a clever, clever oboe. So I texted Leah yesterday evening at 6:18, which would have been 7:18 her time. So
yes.
Leah, see, you're looking better and better all the time. Any letter home you'd like to send for Ho-Wo-Po? I just received a response about 20 minutes ago, coming in under the wire if it's not too late. Because I thought she probably wrote something and forgot to hit send because we had that conversation.
She's pretty bad at that, yeah.
She got this in under the wire. Tell everyone I miss them and the podcast sounded great even without my charming presence. Winky face.
No, it didn't.
Yeah.
Oh, and I loved Sean.
70 degrees was easier.
Yes, it was.
And I loved Sean Flaherty's email on the last one. So we miss you, Leah. Make us proud up at IU, and we'll try not to embarrass you down here in Santa Claus.
It's a noticeable voice. Like, one less person in this room, like, it feels a lot. It does feel a lot different, I think.
It does. And I don't know. I feel like the two of you the table stepped up a little bit more to try to make sure to add some interesting stories and commentary.
Good players.
Eric and
before.
Lauren.
you and I were
the bench warmers, Lauren.
Lauren was good.
Wow. Yes, we are giddy. We've had a whole, it's not like we've had a week off because I don't know, we've all been really busy week. We're all
but rested.
I've been busy catching up on my sleep.
Yeah.
But there's something about the park not being open during the week.
I saw a tree yesterday that was starting to turn and I cried.
starting to turn.
Like, there was this guy
it's
a little
August.
Yellow.
I thought you were
he's dead.
Well, back home, back in New York, they're turning right now. But here, really? Like, it's always summer here.
I thought the point of your story was going to be that you like actually noticed that there was a tree.
Yes,
because you run around so much that
there's many
hey,
trees.
There's a tree. Yeah. We have a tree.
Never knew that.
Yeah,
has yellow leaves. Let's get started with our musings. We wanted to start off. This was a nice surprise at the beginning of this week. Planet Coaster, which is a game, a sim game. Is that what they're called?
It is.
Planet Coaster is going to be released in November, and they
November 17th.
Yes, November 17th. Thank you, Matt. You did
somebody
your homework.
Read the email.
Somebody read the email. Yay. And it was discovered, this has actually been a big secret, it was discovered this week due to their development diary number 4 on YouTube that the park that they visited to get park sounds was
Holiday World.
Woohoo! And did you get to watch the video?
Yeah, it was
yes,
so cool.
It was way awesome.
They had like a big boom mic and they
I
were...
I want to play.
Oh yeah, it looks like a great game. It looks like a great, like you said, like a sim game, but they...
Speaking of the sound, yeah, I mean, it was just, I really kind of got caught up in the sound designer talking about, you know, how it's all made, and he used one of my favorite words.
What was it?
Onomatopoeia.
He said that?
He said onomatopoeia. That was the word that I won the 8th grade spelling bee on.
The guy with the accent?
Many years ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a great accent.
Can you still spell it, Matt?
I can. Do you want me to?
Yeah. Sure. Go ahead.
Onomatopoeia. O-N-O-M-A-T-O-P-O-E-I-A. Onomatopoeia.
There's a T in there?
Onomata? Ta.
Oh, I thought it was mata.
Okay. Onomatopoeia. Dude, I want to spell check. I was spelling the
spell check.
I know.
I want spell check.
I am spell check.
Thank God for spell check.
So when they came out, I'm trying to remember when they came out. Do you remember, Matt, when they were here? It was through a different department, so I wasn't
involved. Yeah, it was the spring.
Was it back in the spring,
yeah.
Like right before we opened? And,
yes.
And Andy from marketing went with the crew from ride to ride. And so we had the great cooperation of attractions and maintenance and everything so they could capture the sounds of different rides. And I think when we first came up with the agreement, everything was before we really knew. They weren't really talking about what they were developing.
Right.
And so we were kind of like, well, we're not really sure. So
what are we giving you rights to?
Yeah. Right. So everything for us was secretive and we swore them to secrecy. And they luckily took some video and included it. So now the secret's out. And when you play that game, you will hear some sounds. That came from Holiday
So
World.
Even though it comes out November 17th, you can go to planetcoaster.com and you can pre-order it now.
Ah.
And they were really, I
have
mean, they
done
were,
that?
I may or may not have done that already.
<That's> even done. They were like up close on some of the rides and then they did like ambient noise. Like it was cool to watch the video because you see they were really trying to get a full picture.
Yeah, it's really, it's the Planet Coaster has a YouTube channel. So just head over there. They've got all kinds of stuff up there and it is really fascinating and it's neat to be part of it. We have congratulations to share with Coaster Radio. They were the first park affiliate, not they're not affiliated, they're industry affiliated, I guess, podcast. They have been podcasting for 10 years.
Oh, wow.
Can you believe it? So Mike and EB, congratulations. Our pod squad sent a little tiny video that someone had asked for and put together a video that's also on YouTube. Congratulating them. It was neat. I don't know if the rest of you got to watch the video, but it was really...
Did. So if we made it 10 years, what pod squad episode would we be on?
Good heavens.
26 a year
26
times 10.
26 times 10, yeah.
I don't do math in my head at this time of day.
Says the CPA.
On our 100th episode, can we have a K?
Can we have a K? Yeah, because you never get food.
People think accounts are good at math.
They don't do math in their head.
Not call out the 10 key. For you young kids, that's a calculator.
What did you call it?
A 10 key.
A 10
Who
key?
Who calls it that?
What's the difference between the C and the CE key? I read something yesterday. It said, I don't always clear my calculator, but when I do, I just hit C and CE furiously until everything goes away. Who doesn't do that?
Whenever I want everything to go away, I'm just like, nah.
Yeah, right. You just hit the button. You just like, something's going to clear it.
Do you hit it more than once?
I hit him several times.
That doesn't clear it anymore.
No, I know, but it's just habit
it's just
to just go.
Like,
and then
that seems obsessive.
It does. It makes me nervous. Stop drinking that.
I was working on budget stuff today. I was like,
all over. How many times did you hit the CEs?
Got to start from scratch.
We accounts will make you hit it again, I'm sure.
Oh, no.
So Mike and EB, here's to another 10 years of podcasting. And we also like to thank them for helping us get started here, because when we were first getting set up and figuring out how to do this, we reached out to a number of the podcasts that are out there that we've listened to, and they were a lot of help, and it was great.
Oh my god.
Somebody just walked in the door. Speaking of food, I told them, just come on in.
Just use the word dude twice on
this
podcast.
This is so much better than last week.
This is way better than last week.
Oh, like, I didn't hear.
Oh, there's bacon on one right here.
All right, you got to tell us what this is.
So, yeah, maple.
Here, you need to use
these are our funnel cake. Okay, somebody's got to take some pictures before this stuff gets...
Yeah, but chocolate lover's madness and a Reese's Pieces.
Say that again, sir, if you don't mind.
So you have a bacon maple, a chocolate lover's madness, and a Reese's Pieces.
That was Justin Rink, our director of food and beverage, by the way, making a surprise visit.
And these will be...
You really stepped it up this week, Justin.
You really did. I'm really scared about this bacon thing, though, after the bacon cotton candy. Like, I don't know what to do.
Yeah, the trust is gone, Justin. You got to redeem.
Is gone.
He's trying to redeem himself with three new funnel cakes. And these will be for happy Halloween weekends. Thank you, Justin.
Thank you. I'm going to wait for Eric and Lauren to try the bacon one
I can eat the bacon.
Okay, try.
Oh, that's right. Are these gluten-free?
Oh, it's the regular.
It's the regular.
Not the gluten-free. So, but she's eating the bacon. Seems to be enjoying that. Okay, Rance. What? Come on.
There's no bacon on that.
There's no bacon?
Oh, okay.
Get bacon in your bite.
Get bacon
well,
in your
bite. Well, it sure smells good. I'll tell you that.
So, what's
really the good. Chocolate lovers? Has that got, like...
It's
Oreos and
it's an actual chocolate funnel cake. So it's chocolate funnel cake batter. And it looks like, there's broken up Oreos on it and chocolate chips.
Chocolate syrup, maybe?
It looks like white syrup of some sort.
Keep us quiet. You did.
So, yeah.
Project. We got a project for this.
And then one has Reese's Pieces sprinkled on it. So it looks pretty darn good. Or happy Halloween weekends, and we'll talk about the start of them here in a little bit.
The bacon is so good.
Oh, the Reese's Pieces are very good.
And what's shiny on the bacon?
Maple glaze.
Syrup.
Oh, okay.
Maple glaze.
That's why he walked into work with a bottle of Aunt Jemima. He's walking through the hall with Aunt Jemima. I was like, Justin, are you having to drink that for breakfast? Because he's kind of, you know.
See, I always worry. I know you two are friends and your offices are close to each other. And I thought, oh, they're going to talk. He's going to know.
He doesn't tell me anything.
To be a surprise. Good for you,
Justin. I let him know my disappointment last week. Well, the kettle corn was great, but you know, I like the experimental stuff.
Right.
Even the bacon cotton candy, it was horrible, but it was fun to try it.
It was horrible.
It was so bad.
It was
not fun to try it.
And listeners, we are not selling that either.
Yeah, like, don't ask.
And if we do, don't feel obligated to buy it.
Ever. Or take it, even if we give it away free.
Right.
Because it was nasty.
It was bad
stuff. It imprints on your memory, your sensory memory.
Does.
It's there forever.
It is.
It's not, we can't scrub it. We can't hit the CE button and make it go away.
And you know how much I love bacon, too, and it kind of tarnished bacon in my mind a little bit.
See, it didn't for me because it tasted nothing like bacon.
Yeah.
But just the fact that they had the word bacon associated with
it. Yeah, that's true.
Like, yeah.
Okay, onward and upward. From Coaster Radio, congratulations to the Hoosier Hospitality Award.
Oh,
yay.
Last Friday, Eric, you went up with, who else went with you for this award up in Indianapolis?
Lori Cotton and Lori Cook. And
how was the drive
winner.
Up?
it was good.
Lori Cook is Lauren's mom.
Yeah, it was a good drive up, but it was an odd trio of us. So it's like,
what
are we going to talk about? I did.
You drove. How'd it go?
It went well.
I went up last year and Lori drove. And I remember there was a new state law about you're not supposed to be in the left lane unless you're passing.
Oh.
And so Lori was
basically drove in the left lane, didn't she?
She what?
She basically drove in the left lane, didn't she?
No, she was following the law. And I was thinking, wow, is anybody really going to do this? And she was like, getting irritated with the people who weren't following the law.
She's going to get mad at me. I love you, Mom. I'm sorry. But you have a tendency to drive in the left lane on the interstate.
She drives very fast, too.
Well, then you have to be in the left lane. Wait, why can't you be in the left lane?
But you're supposed to be passing
only.
But
you can get in the left lane to pass, but you're not supposed to just driving.
She knew she was just going to be passing people.
So a lot of times people get in the left lane and then drive really slow. And then some people who do want to pass can't.
And they have to pass on the right.
And you're not supposed to do that.
No.
That's a no-no.
I feel like that's a rule everywhere. Why is that? Was a new last year?
It's a new, like,
a new law.
As of a year ago.
July 1st.
Yeah. It was an unspoken rule before. Yeah. Now it's like the word.
It's a law now.
But she paid attention to that. I was impressed. Yeah. But we had a good, and I remember the once we got up there, she said, we cannot leave without getting taffy. Saltwater taffy.
She loves taffy.
And lemon shake up. And
she brought taffy home this time too.
Okay, well, good. I'm glad the tradition continued. And so what did you guys get anything interesting to eat up there?
Well, we saw the taffy place, but she was going to wait to get it on the way out. But we stopped at a barbecue place and I had a pulled chicken parfait and we had fried green beans. It was buy one, get one. So Lori and I each got fried green beans, but we actually got four. So we had lots of those.
Wow.
So, do you like fried green beans?
They're so good. Yeah.
Are they deep fried? Like coated with.
It's the state fair. Everything state is deep fair. Fried.
Everything is. Who knows what we're really consuming up there.
So it's very good. It was cool. We didn't spend a ton of time at the fair, but the fair was, it was a great atmosphere up there.
And the Hoosier Hospitality Award is something that the State Tourism Division of the Department of Commerce in Indiana gives out every year. They open it up county by county that every county can potentially have a winner. And we this year nominated someone, and she was chosen as Spencer County's recipient of the Hoosier Hospitality Award. I think there were maybe 18 of the 92 counties that that had recipients. Mm-hmm. So it's a neat ceremony. It's neat to hear the different stories. And who was our winner?
Our winner was ride operator Emily Cron. So she had some great feedback at the beginning of the year. She was patient and spent time getting kids to ride the Voyage when they were scared. And she's just a great representative of our department and our park. So it was well deserved, and we got to meet her mom, and her dad came up with her, which was great that they got to share that experience, and they're great people. So it was so great to see her get the award and represent us.
Emily's a good person. She's great.
She's very cheery.
Always.
Yeah.
And it was really nice too, because when they put out the call for nominations, they ask for stories. So it's not just, oh, this is a really good employee or this person. You have to have a story. And we had just received two emails naming Emily someone who had worked with their child. And she said, my daughter really wanted to ride, but then at the last minute, she got a little scared, but we knew she wanted to ride. And Emily talked to her and took the time, which is so nice because, you know, you want to keep the rides moving, but you don't want to rush so much that you forget that there are little individuals having their first coaster ride. And then she said, driving home, my daughter couldn't stop talking about Emily. And she said she was her new best friend.
That
was really nice when you can touch somebody individually like that.
And it was really cool to hear. You said the 18 counties that submitted and had people. It was really cool to hear the stories of Emily, but then also everyone else. It was fascinating. It was a great little celebration.
It was fun. And then also part of that was the annual Will Cook Indiana Tourism Leadership Award. I had to write that down because it's got like too many words for me to memorize, which is named for Will Cook, Lauren's dad, who we all love and remember. And the winner this year, there's one winner per year, were Bill and Kathleen Oliver from Oliver's Winery in Bloomington. So bravo to them. Okay, now we're going to change the topic completely and go back to Bert the Conqueror.
Emily was on Bert the Conqueror.
She was.
Emily was rode
not riding a coaster.
No, she was riding.
Well, I guess a coaster, but a water coaster.
A water coaster.
But what we've already talked about, kind of frame by frame of the Midwest Mudfest episode of Bert the Conqueror. But we had a chance to show it to the rest of our full time staff this week. We had a lovely luncheon, and that was kind of the entertainment. And it was so much fun just to hear the roaring laughter. And
he's a funny guy.
It was just continuous. I saw people like wiping tears from their eyes. They were laughing so hard.
We got to get him back.
And I think the biggest burst of laughter, of course, was at the high dive pool, going up the stairs in his Speedo, and they showed him from behind, behind being the operative word. And it was just a really funny shot.
As my mom said, though, it could have been far worse. That could have been a much smaller Speedo.
Well, this is true. It was very tasteful. It was considering
very
the park.
Tasteful.
Considering the park
tasteful
he was
tasteful
in.
Tasteful could be. I don't know.
That's tasteful right. And like.
Yeah. But it was funny then when this week, in the aftermath of some of the not so great stuff at the Olympics, that word came out of one of these divers or swimmers no longer representing Speedo, then immediately thought, it's Bert's chance. And I happened to the next day look over on his Twitter account, and sure enough, he's made an audition tape. For did you guys all watch it?
No, I didn't realize there was a video.
I didn't get my browser to load.
Video.
I thought it was just a photo. I have to go back now.
I did a screen grab for you. It's almost... Do not watch in the office video. It's probably more PG-13, but
did he include any footage from the park?
PG-13.
From our park?
No, he's out in a field and he's in a little teepee and bursts out. So I don't know if it's a takeoff of another video. And he's in a much smaller red Speedo.
For all you know, he went and filmed this just for this occasion.
Oh, yes. I'm sure he did. And he's...
I like how you set the scene. He's in a tent in the woods.
He bursts out of the tent. It's a teepee.
Oh, teepee.
It's a teepee. And he bursts out and he starts dancing. It was just, but it's fun. And if you're a Bert fan, even if you're not, run over to his Twitter account because it's pretty darn funny. On to Rock the World. We are all recovering from this crazy weekend. Lauren, how'd it go for you?
It went really well, honestly. I mean, the weather could have been far worse. So we had a slight rain delay, but you know what? It could have been a lot worse.
It could have been worse. We've seen worse.
Yes. And the show got to go on. So I was pretty pumped about it.
And any behind the scenes stories you can tell us?
Yeah.
That's what we really want to hear.
Well, you know, it was just a stressful day all around for me, but... There was one point where our stage manager, production guy, whatever you want to call him, he came over to me and he said, we need keyboard stands. And I'm like, excuse me? And he's like, I need a single keyboard stand and then I need a two-tiered keyboard stand. I was like, where am I supposed to get a two-tiered keyboard stand?
We are in Santa Claus, Indiana.
Apparently, the company that provided the backline brought the keyboards, but forgot to bring keyboard stands. Ooh. So I had half an hour. I had half an hour before sound check to wrangle together some keyboard stands. And so I looked at our production guy and I said, I'm not going to be able to get you a two-tiered right now. Can I get you three singles for at least right now? And he's like, yeah, that'll work at least for sound check. And I'm like, awesome. So for the next 30 minutes, Leah and I proceeded to run around Spencer County and call various people, but we pulled together three keyboard stands. And then
did you find them?
Well, I have to like think through this through. So our entertainment executive producer, Sandy Fortune, she had one. So I got one from her. And then my brother had one. So I got one from him. And then I actually borrowed one from my church.
Wow.
Good job. And for the record, we probably have several at my house too.
I was gonna say,
my son John, I think he's probably got half a dozen.
So next year that happens.
Yes. But then after sound check, unfortunately, they needed the two-tiered keyboard stand. So Sandy Fortune, thankfully, drove to Evansville and picked us up a two-tiered keyboard stand.
You just never know.
Oh, you never know.
Were you afraid when you saw them coming? It's like, from then on, what kind of questions? Oh, we also need this.
All morning, like our production person had been coming over to me and he's like, okay, like we need like some rugs for underneath the drums. And I'm like, I can do that. Like we need some towels, you know, like in case like things get wet, you know? And I'm like, I can do that. And then we need keyboard stands. And I'm like,
I cannot.
Okay.
I will maybe be able to do that.
Well, I'm like, thank goodness. Like I know a lot of musical people.
Yeah.
So
we've come to learn you expect the unexpected.
Yeah, pretty much. That's fair.
And then when the show is over, the concert's done, everyone goes home. Not everyone.
No, not everyone. Home. Not everyone. We actually tear down the entire stage after the concert. So it's kind of remarkable because we set it up and it takes all day Thursday and all day Friday to set things up.
So
and
when
then,
you say stage, it's not like a little platform.
No.
It's huge, that thing.
No, it's quite large. And then you have to bring in all the sound and lighting equipment and set all that up. So yeah, so it takes a full 2 days to set up. And then after the concert's over, we bring in some crews and we start tearing down, and I was hoping the concert ended at about 10:15, and I was really hoping we were going to be done tearing down around like 2-3 in the morning, but we didn't get done until 6 a.m. So
I was, you have a selfie to prove it, which I want to.
I do. Yes.
I'm going to put on the blog if you'll send it to me.
Yes, it's very impressive.
It's very impressive.
Yeah. Like you said, it's not a small step. I mean, you guys put this huge thing up and take it down in just a matter of. Look, the sun's up. That's the worst feeling, right?
Look at their eyes. You stay up
all night. We'll post that photo. Honestly, the worst part was whenever we were like, the sun is coming up.
And it gets cold right before the sun comes up.
It really wasn't that bad.
The temperature drops a little bit.
Not around here. It's 80 degrees at 6 in the morning.
It dips right before the sun. The weather guys who come and do the weather early
in
the
park. Eric's in a full sweat at 60 degrees.
Oh, it's terrible out there.
Well, congratulations.
Oh, yeah, congratulations.
Did you get a couple days to recover, did you just say? Or?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Sunday, I basically just spent the entire day laying on the couch and sleeping. And then every day since then, it's just been trying to write my sleep schedule because it's really thrown off.
You messed up your body.
Well, because like I didn't just, you know, work until 6 a.m. I got to the park at 7 a.m. Saturday morning because we start loading in at about 7:30.
We should have done a podcast that day.
So
next year.
So I was, you know, at work for 23 hours. So that was fun.
Well, you should have worked one more just to say you worked a full fledged day.
You just couldn't do it, could you?
You should see the look she's giving.
I was so ready. The worst part is whenever we're sitting there, they're like, okay, well, morning grounds is here. Morning cleaning has arrived now. Maintenance has shown up.
I'm like, oh no.
Like, we're still here. and other people are arriving to start their day. And we're like, our day's not over.
We will do it all again next year, right?
Yes. So. And I do want to add like one little thing about the artists this year.
Sure.
I thought we had a wonderful group. They were so nice and so friendly, and it was so awesome because a lot of them hung out in the catering tent and just chilled and like talked with us. And, you know, I mean, like they'll always, you know, say hi and stuff like that. But it was really, really cool, like to get to know them a little bit better. So it really made for a neat year.
Cool.
I found out that one of the artists actually lives in the same neighborhood as one of our best friends. So
very crazy.
Crazy.
The guy with the hair, right?
Colton Dixon, yes.
Yes. We have to put up a video that Stephen made during the day where he said which he would go up just randomly to people, I think at the meet and greet during the day, and which would you want to have, Santa's beard or Colton Dixon's hair? And it was funny, the reactions of all the different people he asked. So we'll have to get that video up.
Did you say both?
Both.
Really? You want both?
Oh, yeah.
Hmm. Okay. You're working on the beard. I see that.
I got to shave tomorrow.
Yes, you do. This episode is the one with a see you in September. And September around here is kind of an interesting month in that we're open weekends only. And each weekend is a little bit different. So let's go ahead and talk through the month. So anyone planning to visit knows what they're in for.
Oh, yeah.
First of all, we start off with Labor Day weekend, which is a 3-day weekend. And yes,
it is.
We are open all 3 days.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the third.
Those are very exciting.
It's going to be great. Yeah. We love Labor Day weekend.
Labor Day weekend's fun.
What do you love about Labor Day weekend?
It's a kickoff to fall. All good things come in the fall.
Really?
Pumpkin.
Happy Halloween weekend.
You really like pumpkin.
Happy Halloween weekends, pumpkin, the air, the leaves start to change. Everything builds pumpkins to this moment.
Wow.
Pumpkins, pumpkin spice. Yeah.
Pumpkin
spice
food.
Cheerios. That's new this year. I'll be buying those soon.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I always love
the pumpkin pie blizzards at Dairy Queen. Oh, I think those are like my favorites.
Oh, yes. And I'm sure we'll have plenty of pumpkin offerings.
We have pumpkin pie. That's hard to say.
It is
pumpkin pie.
Flurries. At Early Blue.
That took you so long.
Because I was thinking about the words as they were
mouth,
coming out.
You're probably drooling so much. You're trying to contain it within your mouth.
Right. And I'm currently coordinating my pumpkin order.
That's right.
That's right.
She's the pumpkin queen.
I emailed a question I didn't get an answer to.
She's got like a little tiara that looks like a pumpkin.
I saw an article that there's a pumpkin shortage this year. Is that a concern?
It's such like
I talked to at least one of our suppliers, and he said his pumpkins are just fine.
Good.
Good, so. Because that was really a horrible sideswipe. We're talking about our love for pumpkins, and everyone's having a
good time.
Maybe nationally, but locally, it sounds like we're fine.
Yeah. We buy all our pumpkins locally. Yep. That was the whole point. That was my strategy, Mr. Rentz.
Oh, you were going to bring it around. Okay.
Yes, that we buy our pumpkins locally.
I hear all the pumpkins are dying.
No.
It all comes full circle.
All of our pumpkins, gourds, straw, mums, we get them all locally.
It's just great. So there'll be no shortage of pumpkins at Happy Halloween weekends. But first, we're talking about Labor Day weekend. And on the Monday of Labor Day weekend, if you happen to be in Splash and Safari, you may see a very professional looking TV crew that will be here from the Travel Channel. We're going to have the Travel Channel here on that Monday when the public is here. And on Tuesday, we're going to bring extras in and do some things. We're not going to reveal too much about it other than it will be in Splash and Safari. And I'm sure it'll air next year sometime. Since it's always that delay that you almost forget. And then all of a sudden you find out, hey, we're going to be on TV next week. So that'll be fun. So I was going to say, so wave to us if you see us, but there's no better way to guarantee that you won't be included on something for TV than waving, because they don't want people yelling, hi, mom, and waving. So I guess if you don't want to be on TV, wave, because they will definitely not use that. So that's coming up Labor Day weekend. The following weekend, September 10th and 11th, that is a buyout weekend, meaning that a couple of large businesses in the area have bought out the park just for their employees and their employee families. So we are not open to the public that weekend, September 10th and 11th. That's on our calendar. It's been on our calendar since last fall. And we just like to have the opportunity to remind everyone, please don't show up those days unless you work at one of those companies, in which case you'll have a ticket.
The moose should have told you.
That's right. Poor moose. The poor moose out front. And September 17th and 18th, the next weekend, will be the final weekend for Splash and Safari in 2016. Yep. So that is the chance to come out, and we'll be in the aftermath of celebrating Lauren's birthday.
Yeah, right. It's your close. It's Splash and Safari closing weekend. Lauren's birthday celebration. That's what's happening.
How many
is that
birthday?
On the calendar?
Yes, that's what.
Of
that's
course
what,
it is.
Reminder: you have two upcoming events.
How many birthday parties did you have here as a kid, Lauren?
A few. Not. I mean, like, it definitely wasn't every year. It was a special thing. I don't think my parents wanted me to get used to it.
Okay.
I had a few, you know.
Did you and Leah have combined birthday parties, or did you have separate?
A lot of times.
About a month apart?
Yeah. Less than a month, yeah.
Oh, that's
We had a lot of combined ones. One of my favorites was a combined party where we were closed, so I would imagine it was like a Friday evening probably, and we got to bring in some friends, and we had some pizza and Kringles, and then we got to go over and play skee ball.
Wow.
That's cool.
My parents gave us like a whole, I don't even know if they gave us quarters. They might have just let us play. I can't remember.
But
that was like the highlight of like my life.
It lives in infamy to this day. Do you remember the number of tickets you won that night?
No, I don't.
I was going to say, you're pretty easy to please. I mean, that's a great birthday, but
cheap date. I loved skee ball.
I was waiting for you to say, like, every ride was open. We played skee ball.
I mean,
I would have loved that.
For my 12th birthday, I was in the sixth grade, and I got to invite the entire sixth grade over to the park. And basically, my parents had a picnic then. So, like, we got the picnic meal, and we all met up for lunch, and
that's
I opened
really
my
cool.
presents, and then everyone ran around the park.
So
it was open. Like,
so
it was open to
class?
The public. Uh huh.
Wow.
Wow. Cool.
That's a way to make friends. That's so cool.
Very neat. So then the final weekend of September, well, actually starting Saturday, September 24th is the beginning of Happy Halloween weekends. And there's no stressful look across the table for me. So we'll
the rise of the pumpkin queen.
The pumpkin queen is ready.
Just one more month. I just have to get through one more month, and then I'm just going to be in this place where I'm like, what? Stress? I don't experience that at all. What is this life?
What is this life?
So we will talk
more.
You
know we're having events next year too, right?
Yeah, but there's going to be like at least a few weeks where I'm like,
Just enjoy life.
I don't know how that feels.
So we will talk more about Happy Halloween Weekends in future episodes. But meanwhile, since we've all been treated to three different Happy Halloween Weekend funnel cakes, does anyone have a favorite?
Oh, gosh. I love our food at Halloween time, which I love our food all the time. But anything pumpkin flavored. I love all of our pumpkin flavored.
I think
flavored.
She meant the favorite of the three.
Yeah, I don't see a pumpkin funnel.
No. I agree with you, Matt. I want the pumpkin stuff.
Yeah. I just love pumpkin flavored.
I thought
food.
The Reese's Pieces funnel cake's great. You're totally not answering my question. I'm not used to this.
Well, if I had to pick one of these, I would say the Reese's Pieces one.
The pumpkin.
Whose podcast is this?
Yeah. Yes. I'll send you a memo about that later.
I would say the Reese's Pieces one. But, yeah.
But you're looking forward to the...
I'm hoping for pumpkin flavored something next time.
There'll be pumpkin.
Justin Rink.
Turn that up in your office when you play it back, Eric. So there you go. It echoing down that? The hall.
You've been summoned to the pumpkins.
You've let Matt down. He wants... Because we have pumpkin funnel cakes, right? Those are really good. So, Eric, what did... Of the three your plate...
They're all really good. I like them. I'd say the Reese's is... It's just loaded with so much more. It's a lot going on there. It's good. But the bacon, gosh, bacon works. It works. So I like that also. I can't choose. It's like choosing it's like choosing your favorite child.
That can be done.
Well, actually.
It's really not that hard.
That can be done.
It may change from day to day.
But. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Well, today, my favorite. It really does.
Oh my gosh.
Love you, Claire.
Love you, Claire.
She stopped listening a long time.
She really did. Yeah. We're not funny enough.
Oh, she's the one with the harsh feedback, right?
Harsh feedback.
She's very harsh.
My favorite's the gluten-free funnel cake.
There you go.
That's not one of the picks, Lauren.
You don't scold her for that. You don't scold her for that.
What?
You didn't yell at her.
I'm going
to go
along with the theme.
She'd rather be in trouble with me than in trouble with her intestines. I think that's a fair statement to make.
That is.
All right. Our contest winner last time around was Kyle B. from Evansville, who's been in touch. And the one prior to that.
Congratulations, Kyle B.
And the one prior to that, we had not yet heard from Sean B., but we now have. So all of the tickets are safely to the winners.
Are they related since their last names are both B?
No, I thought it really helps to have, even though it's chosen at random, it helps if your last name starts with a B.
Right.
Oh, man.
Glad you picked up on that, man.
I did. I'm very perceptive that way.
I did think the same thing yesterday. Oh, we'll have a new contest at the end of the podcast. We'll present a question.
Ooh.
And details how to enter our contest to win 2 one-day tickets.
After everything and all over the map we've been, I hope it's not a question about things we've talked about.
We'll find out later. I'll not tip my hand this early.
Good luck to you people with the last name starting with B.
Or any other letter. It is random, I promise you. It is random. Need tickets? Go to holidayworld.com/save, where our tickets are already discounted, and then use the promo code HOOPO to save a little bit more. That promo code is spelled HOWOPO. It stands for our Holiday World Podcast. We are Holiday World and we love holidays.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at what's coming. What was that?
I don't know. You're just like, holidays. Yeah, we do.
So coming up August 26th, which is today.
Hey.
Today is dog day.
Oh.
I saw that in my Facebook memories.
Your dog.
My Facebook memories. It pops up and says like, 1 year ago, you did this, or like 5 years ago, you became friends with this person.
Oh,
yeah. I change your voice.
That's your Facebook voice.
I imagine Facebook talks to you.
So
I have Australian Siri now.
Please expect a photo of Edgar coming later today.
Me too.
Very classy. All right. Yeah, I like him. He's kind of nearly as rude as the Lady Siri.
She's so rude.
She is.
Who's rude?
The Lady Siri.
Lady Siri
on your iPhone.
Oh,
Matt and I both converted to Australian man Siri.
Because the lady's just not nice.
I don't talk to Siri. I've had enough.
I don't either anymore because she never does what I
have
her to do.
I don't even have to press the button anymore. Hey, Siri.
She's not talking to you. You ticked her off.
Hey, Siri. There you go.
I hope she says, hey, is for horses. That's what my dad always said.
You would
say
it in an Australian accent.
All right, then. So
anyway, dog day.
Dog day. Happy Dog Day, Holodog. What does Holodog do on Dog Day? Yeah, remember our mascot, Eric?
He's probably taking a nap today.
Good for him.
He's taking a dog nap.
He knows what to do. August the 28th, which is what, Sunday, is Radio Commercials Day.
Oh.
And did you know you can listen to our radio commercials on our website? You can go to holidayworld.com/podcast, scroll down below where the podcasts are listed. I don't know what to do. It is the children's side of the table. We said that earlier and insulted them both.
To be fair, the majority of the outbursts have been Eric and Matt.
You're just getting dragged into it. I know.
My outburst, but then you can't stop laughing and then I can't stop laughing.
It was because he said, I knew that was radio commercial day.
I'm excited because I saw you getting your phone out. I'm like, we're going to get to hear like an old radio. That's why I was excited.
I'm glad you're excited. All right. But I did want to share that you go to holidayworld.com/podcast. You can hear this year's radio commercials, one of which I do want to play. So, yes, you were correct.
You were on it.
What's better than there's a pumpkin shortage?
Okay. Now listen to this, and then I'm going to have a question for you, which some of you may know the answer to, but just in case. Hope this works. Come on now.
I don't know why I'm holding my ear to my microphone.
Oh. Jim is a dad who just rode Thunderbird at Holiday World and Splash in Safari. I'm going to tell you all about it. As you can hear, he's a little overcome with excitement, though, so I'm here to translate. Jim says, you blast out.
Okay, Jim.
Go from 0 to 60 to upside
person,
down.
Let me stop it for a second. But there is a person in the background, Jim, who is screaming and hooting and hollering. Does anybody know whose voice that is?
I heard Eric Snow.
It is Eric Snow. Our VP of marketing, et cetera. And I never would have guessed it if I didn't know.
You can't put the name and personality with that sound.
Like, describe Eric Snow. It just doesn't marry. Now, it's not this Eric at this table. This is Eric Snow. Describe Eric for us.
Eric is I think Eric and I are a lot alike in a lot of ways, in the sense of we're both pretty reserved and pretty calm and not woohoo, like
mild
you just heard in the radio like commercial.
Temperament.
Yeah, very much so. So yeah, that's why I say it's hard to picture him doing that, even though I know that
he's a ginger. And you remember when he first started and he'd get so red in the the reason I'm saying this.
Oh, well, then that makes no sense why he would do this then.
Is when we would be in our director's meetings when he was new at the park. Right. And if he just had to speak for 20 seconds, he'd get really red in the face. And I think that's a thing with
it still happens
with
sometimes
red hair,
with him, depending upon the audience and the topic.
Rarely, though. I mean, he's God bless him. He's come
a
long way.
We love you, Eric Snow.
I know, and he's probably talking
about actually, not to be funny, but I saw he was wearing shorts, and I was like, man, you have white legs, because, you know, he's
ginger.
But then he pulled his shorts up a little to show where the sun has not touched, and I was like, oh, never mind.
Do you have your sunglasses on?
I was like, whoa.
And that then you plummet back towards the earth and feel like you're totally going to graze your feet on the ground.
Whee!
That you shoot back up in the air and loop upside down again before you're convinced you're going to hit the tracks of the voyage.
Whoa!
And that the next time you twist upside down, that's three so far if you're counting, Jim says, then you fly through the barn where you feel like... Well, I can't very well repeat that on the radio. Look, here comes Jim's wife and kids.
It is scary. That's funny.
Just so you know, I heard nothing. I heard nothing of what the actual man speaking said.
We're all paying attention.
All I heard was the lose.
Well, one of my greatest disappointments in my career has been when I found out about this, and my next question was, do we have video of you in the studio?
We should have.
And we don't.
Oh.
I contacted the agency in Indianapolis.
You tried.
I went after it, and if they did, they destroyed it.
You would think that they would have videotaped
that.
Especially
knowing
their relationship.
I could see him in the sound booth with them going, give us more.
Let me ask
higher.
We do have a photo or two of him that I know I put back in the spring, put on the blog, so you can go back in the Hollow blog
cool.
and just you can just search for Eric Snow and you'll find it. With
they
him
may be holding out on you. Our agency review is this coming week. Let me put some heat on him.
I think you should lean on him hard because that was very disappointing. Because I would love to see the look on Eric's face while he was hooting and hollering. So again, if you want to listen to that and other commercials, go to holidayworld.com/podcast. podcast and do that certainly on Sunday, which is Radio Commercials Day, which is the whole reason we're talking about this.
So exciting.
All right. September the 2nd, next Friday, bring your manners to work day.
Yay.
Good thing it's not a podcast.
I'm taking the day off. Although I think we're fairly well behaved. We're pretty polite to each other.
In fact, I was thinking about to the guests, not to each other.
Okay.
Oh, we're very mannerful.
Mannerful.
We're very polite to the guests. Yeah, right. So we're good.
Shut up, Eric. I was talking.
Oh, sorry. Save it for Friday.
And actually, I mean, we've worked with a group who said we're too nice to each other, that we need to get down.
Get down.
All right. September 3rd is Bacon Day. Yay. Oh, this is when I was saying we're going to talk about bacon later. But apparently there is a controversy. So I went to the place where all the world's truths are told, Wikipedia.
Love.
And it says,
obviously,
of course, International Bacon Day, or just Bacon Day, is an unofficial holiday observed since 2009 on the Saturday before Labor Day in the United States. Labor Day is traditionally the first Monday of September, so they have to explain what Labor Day is. Though a growing faction has celebrated, there's factions. So that means that there's a battle between when Bacon Day is celebrated. A growing faction celebrates Bacon Day on December 30th. And this has been going on since 2006.
I prefer the Saturday before.
Well, really, you know what the answer is. We should just celebrate bacon every day.
I knew that was coming.
Day.
Yeah.
Exactly. And this is all too confusing to try to remember when Bacon Day is.
So just eat bacon every day.
Bacon has certainly had like a resurgence, like a renaissance since like the late 2000s. Do you know what I mean? It's definitely like...
Compared bacon with the renaissance.
Like it's definitely become an art form.
It really,
everyone looked at bacon as just this like breakfast food, but now it's become
It's pig fat.
Well, when you say it like...
I'm just picturing like pumpkins and it's pig fat day.
Gosh, you're day ruiner.
I'm picturing a question on the SAT. Bacon is to pigs as the Renaissance is to... No, you can't do
it's
that.
It's just really gained popularity.
Just bacon is good. Leave it at
bacon
that.
Okay, good. Bacon Day celebrations typically include social gatherings. So... Eric, you have a new house. I expect you to hold a social gathering.
Just as you would gather around the Mona Lisa.
Use bacon in every single dish. Bacon should be used in every single dish.
In which participants
bacon
create,
my pumpkin Cheerios.
Create and consume dishes containing bacon.
Is pumpkin Cheerios a thing?
Yes.
He told us.
He talked about it earlier. He said he was going to go buy a box.
You said something about spiced? Pumpkin. Was it spiced?
Pumpkin spice Cheerios.
Yeah, well, so not the same thing.
No one wants pumpkin without the pumpkin spice. Pumpkin spice is the flavor, not pumpkin.
There's not going to be chunks of pumpkin in your cereal.
That's like a squash. Oh.
Lots of people eat like fruit in their cereal.
Yeah, but pumpkin is like a squash. Are we just explaining this to you now that pumpkin spice is what
flavor? No, you're not explaining it to me. But it's not just the spice that makes the pumpkin flavored foods great.
This is out of control. Our 15th episode.
Sorry.
Which participants hit our point. Create and consume dishes containing bacon, including bacon themed breakfasts. That's not a problem. Lunches, dinners, desserts, and drinks. Has anyone had a bacon drink?
See, that's where I draw the line.
It's like cotton candy. You just don't do it.
You don't mess with my bacon. And the other day when we watched the going back to all things bacon, turned back to Bert the Conqueror, I think, because in the episode that we were in, when he was driving after he was at the park and he was going somewhere, he pulled a piece of bacon out of his pocket while he was driving.
Have you had that in that? The production team was like, have you had that in there the whole time?
He's like, I was waiting to do this bit.
Had it in his pocket. But it was a good looking piece of bacon.
My favorite part was the fact that like he pulled it out and immediately in my head, I'm like, did he really just have that in his pocket for this bit? And then they ask him.
His pocket must be.
And he's like, yeah, I was waiting for this.
It could have been like crispy bacon if it was in his pocket. It would have been all crumbly.
But it wasn't all.
No, it was a soft.
It looked like a pretty good, like well cooked.
And he ate it.
Yes.
So it's not like it was a prop.
No.
It's just a prop.
Could it have been like a gummy bacon? It looked like bacon, but wasn't really.
No, it was.
It looked like bacon.
It was real bacon.
And it looked crisp. So good for you, Bert. You know, Bert will be. We'll be celebrating Bacon Day. September 5th is Cheese Pizza Day.
Ew.
Well, Eric Rents?
What's wrong with cheese pizza?
Well, put some
bacon on it.
You need bacon on it.
Bacon or pepperoni.
Pumpkin. Chunks of pumpkin. That's what we want, pumpkin pizza. Work on it, Justin. All right. September 6th, read a book day. What does that mean?
So he doesn't like to read or eat cheese pizza.
I'm still thinking about the cheese pizza.
It's like the worst day ever for him.
It's going to be a rough week coming up.
What kind of books do you like to read, Eric? Are you a reader? Do you know how to read?
I read your email instructions this week.
You did.
Lauren.
Shush.
And you read a lot of manuals. I know you do
I read a lot at work, but
those have a lot of pictures though.
Yeah. Yeah. I read it. You know, you read a lot.
My sister reads a lot. I read
Leah.
I read some.
A big reader.
I read a lot. Yeah. Too.
What are you reading right now, Matt?
What am I reading right now? I'm actually reading a book by Lisa Scottoline called Corrupted.
Ooh, what's it about? Or do you?
I don't
want
to give it away.
Oh, okay.
Actually, I just started. I'm on like page 25. It's a legal thriller.
Fiction?
Yeah, it's fiction.
Okay. I'm reading Greentown, which I admit I got for $1.99. It's an ebook.
Nice.
There's some new thing I signed up for that every day I get an email with all these really cheap ebooks, and it's like a sale on books. So I got Greentown, which is the story of the very sad Martha Moxley murder in Greenwich, Connecticut, many years ago.
Oh wow.
Which Greenwich wasn't far from where I grew up, so it's a little creepy. But
it's libraries really, and bookstores are like two of my favorite places to go.
Just so you know, because no one asked me, I'm indulging my teenage inner girl and reading the Divergent series.
I hope it's better than the movies.
So far, it is. Yes.
Yeah. I heard those books.
Are those kind of very Hunger Game-ish?
Kind of. Yeah, they're kind of like along that.
Well, I like that series. That was a good series.
But the main character is far more likable because I'm sorry, in the book, I hate Katniss.
For real?
I hate the name Katniss.
See, I prefer her over the Divergent one.
Why did you hate Katniss?
In the book, she's just so like wishy-washy. She's like, oh, I like PETA. Oh, like I like this guy. Like,
you're
oh.
so good with voices.
I like PETA. I haven't read any of those.
I can't handle her indecisiveness.
But she was so protective of her sister.
That's like the one thing she like could decide to do.
Well, she decided to kill a few people.
I'm sorry. I despise her as a character. And in the movies, they glamorize Katniss and put Jennifer Lawrence in the role.
Who's from Louisville, by the way.
And like you can't
so
help.
You ain't for that.
You can't help but like her because it's Jennifer Lawrence. But they portray her completely differently in the movie. She's a horrible person in the books. I'm sorry.
We have so many books in our house that we actually took out. We removed a bathtub to put in extra bookshelves because Carrie buys so many books.
How do you stay clean?
So you have books in your bathroom?
We have four bathrooms. So
you have books in your bathroom?
We have books in the bathroom.
There's a lot of people have magazines. So what's the difference?
So we have this big wall-to-wall bookshelf it's really more of a powder room size bathroom, but it's got this big built-in bookshelves. And our little grandson Cameron, when he's visiting, always likes to have a book with him when he's doing his business, as they say. So Gary was getting him a book, thought he'd bring in Thomas the Tank Engine or something. And he said, no. And he pointed on the shelf. He said, Think Like a Freak. And there's a book, Gary, it's a business book called Think Like a Freak about, you know,
oh my God,
thinking outside a box. But he can read well enough that he could read those words.
Oh, that's funny.
So he's sitting on the potty reading Think Like a Freak.
Think Like a Freak.
He's 4 years old. It's like,
oh my.
A kid. He's fun. He's going to be in the park tomorrow. I cannot wait. And finally, September 8th is Ampersand Day, which I'm very excited. A day for punctuation. Is really cool.
Yes,
Leah, I miss you more than ever right now.
No, I appreciate the ampersand.
The ampersand is a noble
it's hard to write.
Punctuation.
It's hard to write well.
Yes.
Yes. That is, the ampersand used to be the last letter of the alphabet. Who knew?
I did know that at one point.
Did you know that?
I love trivia like that.
So there was 27 letters in the alphabet?
Apparently so. Like, or did it replace something else? I don't know.
Maybe the Z?
Well, I'm not going to do any more research as much as I'm doing about the ampersand.
So is there like a semicolon day too?
I have not come across one yet, but we have not had a full year of podcast episodes. So
this is true.
I do research three different places for these ridiculous holidays.
Wow.
The ampersand is a ligature of the letters E and T, which is et in Latin, meaning and. Isn't that something? The plus sign is actually an ampersand. Isn't that so? We drew math into it too. Isn't this
right? I love math. Wait. I guess I'm struggling though here. Like, so cheese pizza day, I get how to celebrate that. Read a book day, I get how to celebrate that. Like, ampersand day, you just sit around and practice writing your ampersand.
No, yeah, because you need to
appreciate the existence of it. We use it when
so we need to like have a moment of silence here to contemplate the ampersand.
Holiday World and Splash and Safari. The and is an ampersand.
Holiday World, ampersand, oh, Splash and Safari.
That doesn't sound quite as catchy. That's why you're not marketing.
And I wonder how many times I've corrected people. So happy ampersand day.
That's cool. And y'all. I liked all the trivia. You really worked on that.
I did.
Good job, Paula.
Yeah, that was really cool. I like that trivia. 27th letter. That's cool.
I like
cool.
stuff like that. I do too. I hope our listeners are. Is anyone still there?
Hello.
Hello. So, all right. This is our 70th birthday season. We showed some archival footage during our 70th birthday celebration, including some of our rides that were in what is now called Rudolph's Reindeer Ranch, what was once called Pleasure Land. And we got lots of really fun reaction to it because the children riding the rides were all dressed up. They were, the boys were in long dark slacks and white shirts and ties, and the girls were in dresses, and people were saying, wow, people sure dressed up then. And the reason why I put this on Facebook actually the past week is because it shows our very first roller coaster, which was in what is now Rudolph's Reindeer Ranch. And it was an Alan Herschel. A roller coaster, a kiddie coaster called the Little Dipper. We didn't call it the Little Dipper. I think what we just called it roller coaster.
Yeah.
I have yet to find anywhere.
There's a lot of like Herschel Little Dipper models around.
Yeah.
So we just called it roller coaster.
I think a lot of parks, when they had these Herschel models, they called them roller coaster.
They just called it roller coaster.
So creativity wasn't a big thing for us back then.
Apparently,
kiddie coaster renaissance.
They didn't take the time that we take.
You
to
love
name
that word
things.
Today, don't
well, that's
you?
What I'm saying. Those were like the big. That was the big thing in it.
Did they give you free unlimited bacon when you got off the ride?
With pumpkin specks on them.
Bacon coaster.
So because of this and all everyone's reaction to who are these children, it was actually the Santa Claus Land Children's Choir, which existed for, I believe, 3 years in the early 1970s. And Lauren, your dad was a member and some of his siblings. And so we can see him as a child in that video. He was, I think he's the little boy coming down the slide, the rocket slide that we had in the video. We put it on Facebook this week, but I found a news article from 1970 that was in the DuBois County Herald that says Santa Claus Land Children's Choir. Santa Claus Land is going to have a children's choir. William A. Cook, Santa Claus Land president, announced, and this is Lauren's grandpa. We believe the sound of children's voices is one of the most expressive traditions of Christmas, Cook said. We believe also this is part that this part of Indiana has the musical heritage and the potential to produce a first-rate children's choir. So they included information about auditions and such, and they, I believe they got together twice a week for rehearsals and performed regularly in the park.
That's a commitment.
Yeah, it is. Like, and you can go to our YouTube channel, which of course is called Holiday World, and do a search for Santa Claus Land. And we have this wonderful old footage of the Santa Claus Land Children's Choir performing, and they were quite good. And really cute.
So happy we just keep all that. And
I'm so glad we have it.
Yeah, I mean, it's so important for our history. I mean, that's just great.
It's really neat. It's fun. So if you like the history, go back and take a look at that because it's a lot of fun. But I know when I put the roller coaster footage on there from that with the Herschel coaster and said, watch here to see what our first roller coaster is. Does anybody know what our first roller coaster is? And everybody on Facebook just started naming the first roller coaster they ever rode. And I thought,
like
how?
Ever?
Yeah.
The directions
so
weren't clear.
We were, I guess. I know, I went back and I thought, did I miss a word? No, someone else maybe missed a word.
Kind of like your question about the funnel cakes earlier.
It is time for Ho-Wo-Po feedback.
Oh, my favorite. Do your jingle. Oh, Puffy, you did it last time.
Oh, I don't remember what
I did.
We'll
sing the rat song again.
For rats, we travel in pets.
It's Puffy, back on.
All right, first of all, before we start, I must announce that we are now verified on Twitter. We have the little blue ball with the check mark in it, which...
What does that mean?
Eric doesn't know what it means, but I'm really excited about it.
I didn't either.
Yes, we just got it.
I know the symbol, but that I didn't know that meant something.
It is something that has not been attainable in the past. They have just randomly picked out people they thought were important enough to verify. So the Kim Kardashian, right, and big
I'm checking my account now to see if I am.
You are right.
Yours has a big thumbs down. As does mine. That's awesome.
And I get a couple of e-newsletters from social media blogs and websites and such. And I usually just scan the headlines. But one of the headlines a couple of weeks ago said you can now apply. Because in the past, when you look on Twitter, you have to apply. It used to be they just randomly are.
So you're saying there's a chance.
There is a chance.
Let's both apply here and see who gets verified first.
I want to try Leah's oboe, at Leah's oboe, and let's see what happens. You never know.
What is that supposed to mean? It's supposed to mean that that is a legitimate.
It means you get a little blue ball with a check mark in it. That's what it means. It means that you're official.
You're official.
I mean, like for like celebrities,
right?
Like there are several people who will create like a Twitter account like
Bert Kreischer.
Like about that person.
Yeah.
You know, like, but like there'll be the actual person that, and then there'll be people who like create a Twitter account, like just to like glorify that person.
Yeah.
Yeah. So whenever you're, you know, like a little 12-year-old girl and you want to go follow.
Oh, I remember it well.
You know, some teen star on Twitter.
But yeah, that makes
you want to look for that little check because you want to follow the legit one and not the some little fan.
I didn't know that's what that meant.
Yep, so now you need that check
because
someone's going to follow the imposter record.
Exactly. Who's going to pretend to be me?
I can't imagine.
Me either.
First, we heard from Nathan Slater. Do you remember Nathan from Hollywood Nights?
Yeah.
He is a really great guy. And if you remember him, it's because a couple of years ago, he was the guy who vowed to never take off his wristband from going to the
park. Rise against, probably.
And I think once a month he would post on the Hollywood Nights Facebook group this picture, and it was getting more tattered.
The infection was getting worse.
Didn't it like turn white? Like all of the color and print lost came off.
Which, it got a little frightening.
Tells us he showered.
Yeah. So yesterday, actually, he tweeted, "Hey, Holiday World, I just bought a Prius." And then he attached this and said, "Should I?"
Oh,
and he took a picture of a license plate that he could have. He's out of Missouri, and the license plate says, "Ho-o-po."
Please
do it.
So, yes, we responded with our thumbs up and a little Santa face.
You have to keep us posted.
So
we need a picture of that on the Prius.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, we would love to see that.
Oh, that's so cool.
And so, of course, then he responded with, "No, I get a free season pass." And I said, "You get a hug."
It would be a virtual another wristband.
And another wristband.
A shout out on the podcast.
Yes, Nathan. That's really cool. Thanks for thinking of us, Nathan. Yeah. Then we had great excitement this week when work began on cleaning the water tower, outside of the water tower.
That was actually really exciting.
You want to talk about it a little? And this was actually, the water tower itself is, I think everyone knows, the second sun in the sky.
Yes.
That the big yellow water tower, because of its...
But Lauren and Leah did not want to be painted yellow.
That's right. But Will did it anyway, and it does look kind of cool.
Yeah, we embrace it now.
We embrace it. We love it now. But it because of its cylindrical shape, when the rains hit, the rainwater kind of just drips down underneath and then stuff kind of just hangs there. So the underside of the ball portion,
it doesn't get hit with the sun to dry.
Right.
That's right. Which I used to think it was rusty or something. I thought, this is gross. We have to do something about it. It's like, no, it's just it's needs dirt, to be sprayed off. But it's 14 stories tall. It's as tall as Thunderbird.
Oh.
And so what goes into cleaning it, Matt? Do you know the details?
Yeah, we have to send our guys up on these big, huge man lifts, and they power wash them, and it's looking pretty darn good right now. And you posted some pictures, didn't you?
I did. Yeah. And that's why I came up on Twitter. But do we have a 14-story long hose?
That I don't know.
Because we bring a special company in to do it, right?
Yeah, we do. We do. And the company...
A little spritzer.
The company that we got the water tower from, Pittsburgh Tank, they work with us to come in and help facilitate the cleaning of the tank.
So we had a couple of, and God bless Tommy Johnson. He's up there in the man lift and he's taking pictures for me and sent us like, "Whoa, what's this?" And so a couple of them I went ahead and tweeted out. And so Brent D, which is at Brent D86 on Twitter, says, "Holiday World, just curious, does the water used to wash the tower come from the tower?" I thought that was a great question. It was too
mind
deep.
Blown.
That's deep, right?
That's what it did to me. It's exactly.
I was waiting. I was like, "Gotcha. Like, should I know the answer? Should I know?"
And that's what I tweeted back. I said, "Is this like chicken or the egg?" I can't handle this. Sorry, we're not open today. I cannot handle this. So he was very good natured about me not knowing the answer, but one would think.
The water all comes from the same source.
That's right, the heavens. Then Upstop Media, at Upstop Media, Scott said, new goal in life, climb the water tower.
Oh, we advise against that.
Yeah. Please. Ride the coaster instead.
Ride the coasters.
Anyone has, I know some people love that kind of thing, and it is a, obviously Scott
not
does.
Here.
Not me. I can't even sit at the bottom and look up. It's, have you ever been inside the base?
No.
It's just terrifying. Yeah,
and you can see everything. Like
there's stairs. There's a little ladder, or a big ladder, a very long ladder. And you
that
go
part's
up the middle.
That's actually kind of cool.
Yeah, as long as you're not the one climbing
right.
it. And then you have to wear all this safety gear so it weighs you down. And it's hot in there because there's no fan.
I'd imagine it's hot everywhere.
Yeah, but. It's just... It is. And it's the big sun. So, yeah, of course, so it's beaming down. And
it's like 485,000 degrees.
Yeah, the boiling water in there.
So don't hold your breath, Scott. But
wow.
I guess that's what goals are for. All right. Next, we heard from Coaster Radio. We'd already talked about it being their 10th anniversary. And they said, thanks for being part of that video. And we were the only park represented.
Oh.
There were lots of people at other parks, but we were the only park staff. And we were first on the video.
Yes, like, we were.
Wow, that was really nice.
Thanks.
But it was kind of fun, too, because I recognized, did you recognize a lot of the names of people? Mm-hmm. Like, oh, I know this
one. Faces tonight, yeah.
Yeah. So that was a lot of fun. And they put, a lot of Coaster Radio's best moments have been with you guys.
Aww.
That was really nice. Then Jonathan LaPolt, which is at LaPolt. Oh, that's it. And that was the date. Love those guys over at Ho-Wo-Po. Smiley face.
Thanks, Jonathan.
Nice. And then BW Theme Park said, way to go, Pod Squad. Best park with the best people. Even had an oboe cameo that was in the... Remember, yeah. Leah had the oboe on her lap during our little video. And Matthew Summers, he's our at Shang-Lying. Awesome work from the Pod Squad. Hashtag Ho-Wo-Po.
I think you pronounce that differently every time.
I do. I know. I thought, okay, here's my chance to get it right. It's like, no.
Well, you're never going to know which one was right.
I wasn't going to draw attention to it this time.
He needs to tweet the pronunciation.
And yes, Matthew, please. And Matthew was in the video. I remember saying, it's like, oh, that's Matthew. Yeah. Oh, he's nice. So thank you, Matthew. Sorry to... Well, it's not like it's his name. I mean, it's his Twitter handle, so that's not quite as offensive.
It might be his nickname or something.
Well... Yeah, like the Spooner Man. Remember that?
Oh, I remember.
That was episode 3 or 4. That was a long time ago.
Yeah.
Anyway, next we have a couple of questions. The first is from the Amusement Wire, which is at the Amuse Wire. Question I have. Let's see. I have what question I have.
Oh, my gosh.
When you don't use punctuation, it's just kind of hard to read.
It's not ampersand day, though.
No. Question I have. What are your off-season challenges as other parks do holiday events? And then we also heard from Christopher Knight at Coaster. Christopher Knight.
He was on Brady Bunch.
Yeah, that's Peter.
Peter Brady. Pork chops and applesauce.
What does he want to know?
And applesauce. No bacon?
Not for the Bradys.
Okay. Well, he also goes by Coaster Chris 24 on Twitter. And he says, do you guys have any plans for 2017? If so, when are you guys going to announce them? So I thought we'd go ahead and chat about the eagerness of our fans wanting to know what's up and the thought of being open at Christmas time. It's always a question that comes up. And I must say, I will never forget the day we opened Thunderbird, which was a very, very, very long day and a wonderful day. And I went back to the office and one of my emails of probably 300 that had accrued over the course of the day was, yeah, okay, but what's for next year?
Oh.
Just like, so it's a question we hear quite often. And I don't know. What are we going to say?
Well, you know, when you ask the question, what are your plans for next year? I think, you know, we have plans every year for something. And, you know, where we're at right now is, you know, we're thinking about what's going to be the best thing for our guests and what can we do that's going to add the most to their experience and what's going to make their day that much better and memorable for us. So, you know, we'll keep taking feedback and those plans are under works. And as for the holidays, you know, we're Holiday World. So we love hearing that, you know, other parks are doing things and seeing what they do and celebrating the Christmas season that we so dearly love.
Yep. Cause that was the big season in the beginning of Santa Claus Land. Was it? And some people have asked that too. It's like, why aren't you open at Christmas? And that really happened a long time ago because I remember your grandfather, Lauren, Bill Cook, saying that it was really in the 70s and the late 60s that malls started getting Santas. The malls were popping up all over the country. And so having Santa, even though we had the real Santa here, it just wasn't quite as much of a draw. And so that's when the family kind of shifted toward wanting to be a summertime park. So it's interesting, and who knows what the future will hold. But it's something, too, that we have to balance between what we want and what we need,
right,
what the guests want and what the guests need. So
absolutely,
you find that balance. And that's usually what we end up with when we come up with our list for each new year, is finding that balance. And we'll talk about it this fall sometime. We don't have a specific date, but if you're tuning into the podcast, you're tuned into us enough that you'll be among the first to know. Next, we heard from Dan, the t-shirt guy, who sent us two tweets, a two-parter. And he said, explanation for Ho-Oh-Poh. Nickname comes from Coaster Radio for my extensive park shirt collection. Oh, okay. So he's not a purveyor of t-shirts, which is what I had assumed. He said, I am well known for my custom airbrushed ones for milestone coasters and parks. See photos. 500th coaster shirt currently in the works. So he's got a Holiday World shirt and some other shirts. So apparently he has very large closets.
So Dan the t-shirt guy, I think you need a Ho-Oh-Poh shirt now.
Yeah. All right. Start working on it, Dan. We'll be watching. Next, we hear from Preston at Preston_Blake_. And this was in response to a picture that we put up. Remember a couple weeks ago that Brad, one of our coaster cats, is a certified diver.
Right,
and so he went down to do the annual inspection of the piers where Raven, as you all know, takes a swoop out over Lake Rudolph. And so he, as a certified diver, was able to go inspect the piers and make sure they're still in good condition, which they are. And so we posted a great picture of Brad in all his gear and everything, and named him as one of our coaster cats. So Preston asked, don't cats not like water?
that's like, a good question.
Preston, this is typically true. However, coaster cats are a special breed that do.
At least Brad.
Yeah.
And he has the certification to prove it. So thank you, Preston. Good catch. Next, we hear from Ribs and Bacon. And he was asking if Mick Foley would be a guest on the podcast. So we've yet to hear back from Mick. But Mick's Holy Moly show has started. I haven't watched it yet.
Really?
But Mick has his own show now, his own reality show
called
Holy, and it's H-O-L-Y. Remember, I was wondering how they were going to spell it. It's Holy.
That's right. That's right.
So it's on. Does WWE have their own TV channel, or?
I'm not sure.
But
probably on like Spike or something.
Maybe.
Yeah. I'm thinking it's a WWE. So anyway, we will report back if we're able to find this out. Also, Ribs and Bacon was quite talkative this time around. He says, if you guys have buffalo chicken strips in the park, I dare you to eat them on Ho-Oh-Poh. Do we have buffalo chicken strips?
We, not strips, but we do have boneless wings down
really
at the water
good.
Park.
Mm-hmm. He dares us to eat them.
He dares us to eat them.
We'll take that dare. Yeah. Those are good.
Thank you for bacon flavor kind of candy.
He said it's my allowed part.
Oh, I know where that's coming from, because we thought the apple fritters looked like boneless wings.
That's right.
You
that's
did.
Right.
I didn't.
They did, though.
They looked like fried apple fritters to me.
I agree
so
with you.
So we would do that for you, Justin Rink. Are you listening?
Poor Justin.
I would like chicken and potatoes next week. Thank you.
French fries, any kind of French fries I'll take.
Yeah, can we just put our menu
with the garlic parmesan
speaking
seasoning?
Speaking of that, Lauren, Ribs and Bacon also asks, have you guys ever tried poutine?
Poutine.
Poutine.
Now, I researched the pronunciation. This is a Canadian.
Poutine is Canadian.
It's poutine.
Fries with cheese curds and gravy. I used to go to Le Ron all the time and get them.
Fries with cheese and brown gravy is what.
Yes.
Or disco fries.
Poutine.
Disco fries. So apparently we have tried them, but not at the park.
I can ask the Australian guy how to say it.
I don't think at the park.
Hey, Siri.
I listened to like five different YouTube pronunciation things, and the people who sounded most reasonable said poutine.
When I go to Montreal, that's a common dish. Yeah.
Anyway.
Very good.
So there you go, ribs and bacon. All we care about is pronunciation.
I don't know if we're ready for poutine here.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
We'll the
restaurants it's a little too out there.
One of the restaurants at Epcot has poutine.
Well, wait, didn't we? I want to say one year we did have fries with gravy and cheese.
Oh.
Maybe we did.
Down at Bahari Snacks.
But like cheese curds.
I think we had it for
like
1 year.
At Bahari Snacks. I think you're right.
Cheese curds.
I think you're right.
What did we call them?
Well, just like loaded
fries with gravy.
Fries. It might have been bacon on it also.
We called them gravy and cheese
curds. Probably bacon. I probably did.
Probably.
It's very good.
And finally, we heard from Alyssa W., which is at AKWEIHE. That's Alyssa Y. I have We Are Dinosaurs stuck in my head since 8 a.m. All I want is a second verse. Ho-o-po-problem. I bet you could
make the second verse is about mice and rats.
Yeah. Maybe, you know, us revealing we're rats who travel in packs is, you know, better than a second verse.
Maybe.
I hope that, yes, she's able to accept that as...
that is the answer.
And finally, the Coaster Crew, which is at Coaster Crew, has sent us...
Oh, here we go.
Says, checking the mail. So Kitty Claus is going in the little mailbox for our Black Cat Appreciation Day. And oh, I love right. my feet day presents from Holiday World. So they yes. have Kitty Claus is propped up on the big green foot.
We want the book.
Where are the others?
Taking I hope out. You know I debate
it's
every...
Black Cat Day.
I know,
they
but I
matter.
Live for the expression.
Every
the
time
others.
We record the podcast, I debate, like, should I actually go, like, follow them on Twitter? Yes. But I think it's almost better for me to, like,
you don't
experience
see
it.
Yeah.
Live. When we're recording the podcast. Yeah, because otherwise I'd have those reactions in my office and no one would see them.
Exactly. I'm glad you bought into that theory of let's wait. Let's wait. It's that time again. 70 degrees of separation.
To our
your sound makers, you've heard the theory of 6 degrees of separation, right? Well, for our 70th birthday, we made up a game called 70 degrees of separation. Our contestants are given the name of someone or something or an occurrence that is connected with the year 1946 and must figure out the connection to us. Last week's winner...
Paula.
Oh, yeah. That's 2 weeks in a row.
We're so happy for you.
Yay, Paula.
It was close between you two.
Really?
Yeah. Eric was... No.
That was the Pollyanna.
Oh, yeah.
That,
yeah,
that was pushed that over the edge.
Was. That was a fun one to listen
also,
to.
Also, can I just say, guess it was on TV last night.
Pollyanna.
No way.
No, it was The Parent Trap. And it was a new one. It wasn't the Hayley Mills one, but still.
So it was the Lindsay Lohan version.
Yeah, but it still felt appropriate, and I watched it.
It's funny. And when my husband and I were listening to the last episode, and I didn't get Dick Wolf immediately, he was just astounded. He kept going. I said, wait, just wait. I'll figure it out eventually.
To it back, I was like, why didn't any of us like?
Yeah.
Did he mind being chastised that we didn't approve of him not liking the Beatles very much?
Oh, yeah. Has he packed his bags yet?
We're still cohabitating.
You've invested too much at
he
this
thinks
point,
like
right?
a freak.
He's
so
all
I'll
needs
keep
in
him.
The bathroom, the books. Exactly.
Poor guy. He said, I told you that. It's like, I would have remembered that. But, okay, the 70 degrees of separation. We need a sound from each of you. Matt, are you ready with your mammoth call? And Eric with your whistle?
Oh, I'm on vibrate. Hold on.
Oh, dear. And Lauren.
That's so much better than the real thing.
It is. It's better.
It's less jarring on the ears.
It is.
Yeah. So we thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Okay, are we ready to go?
No.
I think so. Maybe.
Be a sore loser.
It's a great time to get
you might be able to win this time.
Whatever.
All right. The first one, and this I found out on the day of our birthday, that it was our 70th birthday, because this year is also the 70th birthday of an organization in Evansville that also began in 1946 called the Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center.
Well, that's not the, is that the thing?
Is what the thing?
That was the
Lauren
clue.
Was the first.
Yeah.
Seals, she let you win last week.
But Easter Seals was the connection? Oh, God, you didn't explain
no, Easter
it.
Seals is the thing.
Oh, I didn't. Now I get it.
So,
no more funnel cakes for you. You're getting hopped up on sugar.
He was hopped up before they ever
this
came
is
in.
That's true. All right, Lauren.
So, Easter Seals. Every
and
year,
you do get a point for being first. I'm bringing that rule back.
So, Easter Seals. Every year, we have what we call Play Day, and it's a day that we are not open to the public and that we donate tickets to Easter Seals, and whatever they sell the tickets for, they keep that money and it goes to their facility and helping, you know, like to give them better
Therapy.
We
had to write a lot of therapy for children who can't afford it.
But it's a really wonderful day because the kids and the adults as well get to come and enjoy the park at their own pace. They're not rushed by, you know, people who are, like, might get frustrated that, you know, taking a little bit longer to get on the ride. So it's all about them, and they get to have a wonderful, wonderful day. And it's honestly one of our favorite days as well.
Oh, as 100%.
Employees.
Because it's a wonderful day.
Like, I don't know that there's ever a crowd with bigger smiles.
That's right. Very good. Yes, that is correct. Yes, Matt, what do you have to add?
Hers was the right answer.
It was the right answer.
And if you say it's not the right answer, it was a partial correct answer.
I got to give something. So Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center has Easter in it. Easter is a holiday. Mm-hmm. We're Holiday World. We don't have the Easter section, but we could one day.
But we have seals.
We're always thinking. We will never have seals.
It's probably a seal day.
Of the mammal type anyways. That's maybe the adhesive,
maybe
perhaps.
Maybe seal could come perform.
We seal our food.
Yes. And then my other one is, so one of my favorite memories of my time here at Holiday World happened at Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center's play day that we host, when I had a little kid run up to me, give me a hug, and told me that he loved me more than granola bars.
Aww.
And his caregiver said, you have no idea how much big that is.
How much he loves granola bars.
So I'm like, that just validated to me how much joy this day brings to those guests. And to beat a granola bar, heck, I'll take it.
I remember one year hearing a story about a child who needed to do extra therapy to be able to get around the park better because she'd had such a hard time the year before. And they were so thrilled that that had really given her a goal to work toward, and she'd improved tremendously. Good. So that makes you so happy. Yes, Eric.
Well, I would like to share a story about play day, which is when the Easter sales come. No, I just think we get a lot of help during our school preseason. And then at the end of the year, when schools are going back in session, from all of our full-time team who come out and work on the rides and help out because our staff is still in high school maybe. And there is not a day more than play day where people are genuinely like asking, can I help? Can I help on play day? Can I help? Because they just love going out there and being with the kids who come, and it's just the most fun day to work, really. Lori Cotton, one of the attractions managers, says that's her favorite day of the year, just because it's so fun to go out there and just everyone's so happy, and, you know, I should get points for that. And Easter's the holiday, and we seal things.
I already said that.
We seal food, and we...
See, you're just hurting yourself.
Oh. How do we seal food?
When at the end of the day, we have to seal it, you know, to put it back in the fridge, maybe.
Maybe. Ew, that sounds kind of... gross.
We're sealing our gates at the end of the night. What are you pointing at?
A ceiling is above us.
There's a ceiling.
No, I'm not.
Is seal still a word?
Yeah.
I've heard it.
I'm thinking
times.
Like seal, like we seal the drink stations at the end of the night by closing the doors, you know?
And we seal the deal by making it a great day for our guests.
And Easter next year is the last Sunday of April.
Stop. Just eat more of your funnel cake.
Which is when we open in April.
Oh, it's the second to last Sunday in April.
But we still open
what
in
is?
April.
That's right.
What
Easter.
Is? Oh, Easter.
Easter.
No, Easter
Sunday.
Moves. Easter moves Easter around. Moves.
Next year, it's the second to last Sunday.
Oh, you already
April.
Have that.
We have
out.
To think ahead, Paula.
Oh, for training and everything.
For training, yeah.
Oh, good for you.
It's that time of year.
That's good.
She's thinking of Rock the World a year later. We're thinking of training.
And for anyone who says, I have a child who'd love to come to play day, you do need to get an invitation, you need to contact Easter Seals Rehabilitation Center in Evansville directly, and they'll put you on the invitation list. And it is for school children with disabilities. And it's a wonderful, wonderful event. And I recall hearing about a park in the Midwest who had done something kind of similar years and years ago. It was my first year of going to our trade show at IAPA, and somebody was talking about it. I remember I went back to Will and said, could we do something like this? And he immediately said yes. And that was one of the happiest moments in my career. It was just, it wasn't, let's figure out this, that, and the other. It was just like, that sounds like a wonderful thing to do. Let's do it. And we've been doing
it
ever since.
That is so cool.
And there's one more piece that has been left out. Dang it. Squeak. Lauren.
Is it that the proceeds from either last year or this year's play day are going to help, I guess
rehab, actually.
Rehab one of their playgrounds.
Yes.
And it's going to be renamed the Will's Way Playground. after my dad.
I got a chill just hearing that. And your mom came up with that name, which is wonderful. I know we're all thinking, what should we call? And they were saying, well, do you want to name it? What should we call? And your mom came up with Will's Way, because where there's a will, there's a way. And that just, it's so neat since he's the one who really got it all started. And
thank goodness he had such a good name that we can play off.
It wasn't Keith or George or something. It would have been a little more of a challenge.
Cornelius Park.
So very good. Yes, that is the
score.
That is the complete answer.
Good job.
Very, very good.
So basically, Eric, you and I don't need to play the rest of the game because it doesn't matter.
He did really well with that one.
Well, this next one, there's a right answer and a wrong answer. There's no need to be clever or witty or anything like that.
Dang it.
It was another, and you love trivia there, Eric Rent. So it was something that I just Googled what happened in 1946. In 1946, a driver in this city placed a phone call in 1946. It was the first AT&T mobile telephone call.
So in 1946?
In 1946, someone driving in a
Santa Claus.
It was.
They didn't have cell phones in 46. What are you talking
about? And the city that it was in is one of the markets we advertise in. Go ahead, Eric Rentz.
So I just want to clarify, you're talking a cellular phone in 1946.
A mobile telephone call. AT&T.
This was in Nashville.
Wrong.
No.
Next.
My answer.
No, it's one.
Oh, that was right. St. Louis.
Yes, that's
Dang
correct. Very good, Matt.
Well, I need to know more about this.
That's all they had was one line. A driver in St. Louis, Missouri placed a phone call.
Like on a
it was
car
the
phone?
First AT&T mobile telephone call.
A mobile
call.
Phone.
Not in 1946.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Who are you going to challenge with this?
I'm going to find out more about this. I'm going to find out more. This can't be right. 1946. There was
when you come down
phones.
Off your sugar high, you're not even going to remember
in the 80s when like
this.
The 80s
back
when
phones.
Well, yeah, or the yeah, brick on Saved by the Bell, Zach Morris's phone. Remember that thing was the size of his locker. And the cars. I remember when car phones were popular, like in the 90s.
They were in your car.
They were recorded. Yeah. They weren't.
They could not come out of your car.
Right. And they had like the curly cord kind of thing too. Yeah. It wasn't like.
I'm gonna get to the bottom of this, by the way.
All right. Thank you, Eric. You get right on that.
You're welcome.
You might need to go to St. Louis to research it.
You'd like that, wouldn't you? But
can I clarify that if he does prove that this is wrong, I still get my point right.
And you get more than one point, man.
Well, yes. If I prove it's wrong, I clearly have won.
Not to the lady that's organizing the game today.
Need tickets? Go She's to holidayworld.com.
Wow.
It's bring manners to work day coming up, dude.
Yeah.
Get ready for it.
You better stay home that day, too. Go to holidayworld.com/save, where our tickets are already discounted. Use the promo code HOWOPO to save a little more. Be sure to enter our contest because you could win 2 one-day tickets. Simply email us at contest@holidayworld.com by 2:30 p.m. on September the 7th, 2016, and tell us what you do for a living. I thought that would be fun. So there's no right or wrong answer. We just want to know. Oh, and by the way, 86% of the last contest entrants said we should continue 70 degrees.
Really?
Oh, my 86%.
Gosh. The other 13% were in this room.
Are they going to call in and facilitate the game?
We should, you know what?
86 plus 13 I think they're onto equals your quick math was
99.
Sorry, I meant the other 14.
Keep him in a trick.
Clearly, he's
out
not
of
a CPA
finance.
Either. Oh. Hit the CE button too many times.
Now, what were you saying? You were very.
I just think
there.
I think he was onto something. I think okay, who wants to get us a couple great 70 degree examples?
But then, how would we know what their answers are?
What?
Like they would run the game.
Who?
Writers.
The listeners. The 86% of the people that said yes. So was this like?
Put your money when you put your
and
money.
Two of them said yes, and one said no.
Would not have brought about 86%.
You know that.
86 out of 100 said yes.
So there were 100
but there
votes?
Was one person who no. There was one person who voted twice using two, which is allowed using two different email addresses. Voted yes one time and no the other time.
Cancel your vote.
Hedging his bet. effectively. So we will announce the winner chosen at random during our next podcast episode. Again, we're just asking you, what do you do for a living? It would be fun to find out who our listeners are. One entry per email address, please. You must be at least 18 years old to enter, and no Holiday World and Splash and Safari employees or their immediate family members are eligible to win. The winner will receive 2 one-day tickets to Holiday World and Splash and Safari. We hope you will join us next time in 2 weeks, where our episode will be the one with the IT guy.
Oh!
Thank you to Stephen Rutherford for making us sound so good and for getting pretty darn excited about the YouTube video explaining Prince Rupert's drop, I Knew You Would. It's on the Smarter Everyday channel if you want to see what we're talking about. It was really, really cool. Thanks to the future Mrs. Hinkle. This is the final time we will call her the future Mrs. Hinkle.
So what was that?
It's getting excited.
Best wishes to Lauren
and Anne.
That's the seal. Oh, best wishes to Lauren and Andy, our favorite holla couple, on their wedding next weekend. Thanks to all of you for listening and hanging in there with us. Please subscribe and tell all your friends on behalf of our Pod Squad. Matt, Lauren, and Eric, thank you. And please be sure to send us your feedback and questions on social media using the hashtag HoWoPo.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World Podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.